Now comes the cool thing. And it's so cool, we call it a trick. I mean, not too many things in science are called a trick. And this is called the kernel trick, all right? We saw that the linear classifier only depends on dot products. Remember that? I circled it, I jumped up and down a bit. So let's define some function k of two points, xi and xj, as just being the dot product, okay, between them, all right? If I map a data point to some high-dimensional space, so my function phi here maps x to phi of x, all right? Then the dot product, whoops, I actually should write it this way, right? The dot product k of xi, xj would become phi of x transpose phi of xj. That's what's written right there, okay? And in fact, what I'm actually going to do is I'm just going to redefine k. Instead of just being the dot product of xi and xj, I'm going to have a new k, right, which is just this dot product of the higher dimensional space. K stands for kernel, okay? And it's a kernel function, and it can be thought of as a similarity function. Similarity functions, the idea is that they get bigger, more similar things are, and you know, dot products can go from, you can either think of it as minus one to one, which is true, so the idea is being the most similar is one, least similar is minus one, okay? And a kernel function is a similarity function that is the dot product, sometimes called the inner product, of the higher dimensional space, okay? So I'm gonna show you an example in a minute, but basically the idea is, if I give you a function of x1, of xi and xj, some function k, as long as there's some higher dimensional space in which that function is just the dot product of that higher dimensional space, that kernel is a dot product. And therefore, it can be used in our linear classifier. There's a whole bunch of theory there about what are called Mercer kernels, which have to do with what types of kernels are acceptable. You basically have to end up with these positive definite matrices between your points, a couple of other constraints. Most of that doesn't matter. What matters is that you can show that essentially it's a dot product. And it turns out a lot of functions are.